Hello and welcome to this week's edition of Walking in His Presence. I'm Pastor Dave Lasek, pastor of In His Presence Church right here in the South Hills area of Pittsburgh, and it is my ultimate pleasure to come to you on a weekly basis and share with you, as God lays on my heart, the different messages and different themes that we've been walking through here in the past couple of weeks. If you happen to be walking by your TV and you just happen to flip on this, just know that we've been praying for you. We believe that God brings to the TV and to this show, both here and via YouTube around the world, those whom He has and whom He wants to speak to. And so if you just flipping through the channels and happen to see that, just know that we're praying for you. And we're so glad that you're with us today. Do take note of the time and the channel, though, because you can see us every week at this same time on the same channel that you're looking at right now. And we're so excited that you tuned in today. What we've been doing is we've been going through some of the major themes, some of the major doctrines of the Christian church. You know, we all come from different backgrounds. We all come into the body of Christ and with different backgrounds, different teachings, perhaps different even upbringings. And maybe whether you're recently received Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, or you grew up in a Christian home, many times what we're sharing is something that maybe it's the same information, but with a different perspective. And that's what we hope to do. We hope to do things that in your walk with Jesus, it just begins to make you think, hey, you know what? I understand what He's saying, but I never considered that point of it. That would be our greatest compliment. That would be the greatest thing that we could be used of the Lord to do, to not only draw those who don't know Jesus in a personal way, but also for those of you who have been walking, you know, 5, 10, 50 years, but you hear the same doctrine. It's not going to be the different doctrine. It's not heresy in any way, but you hear it from a different perspective. And those are the kinds of things, what I've seen in my walk is that those are the kinds of things that's the actual work of the Holy Spirit to shed some light, to bring something new. You know, Jesus walked and talked with His disciples. He celebrated all the feasts of Israel. And they had grown up doing that. But when He spoke the gospel, when He began to show them that each of those feasts have a specific meaning, and that He was actually embodying God and fulfilling those meanings, that's when things get exciting. And for you, I would hope that's the very same type of experience that this show brings to you. Whether you've been just tuned in or whether you've been watching for a while, we're so excited that you have. We would hope that this show is just something a little different, just something that makes you consider it, consider the scriptures, consider these different theological positions, these different things of our Christian walk a little differently. We've had shows, and recently I had the two pastors here from our church plant in Lima, Peru. And if you tune in again in the upcoming weeks, one of those pastors will be back with me. The other is going back to take over things again and back in Lima. They'll be flying out even today as I'm speaking. They're going to be heading back to Lima. But Pastor Arturo will be here with us, and we will have some tremendous discussion. So again, take note of the channel and the time that you're tuning in, because we'd love to have you with us in the Bethel Park and Peters Township area. Our church is actually located at 251 Brookwood Road, and we're in the education building of Peters Creek United Presbyterian Church. And we meet there every week at 10 a.m. And one of the things that we do that may be a little different than maybe even your Christian upbringing is that we celebrate the feasts of the Lord. We celebrate those feasts that in the book of Leviticus are set apart and designated not as Jewish feasts for only for the Jews, but they're actually listed as the feasts of the Lord. So what I want to do is, if you have a Bible and you can follow along with us, that would be great. If you want to just follow along as I read, that would be okay too. I'm going to be flipping back to Leviticus chapter 23, because in that context, the Lord begins to explain through Moses his heart about these particular feasts. And let me just grab my glasses here, and we can go ahead and take a look at what the Lord says. In Leviticus chapter 23, the Lord says, "And the Lord spoke to Moses," I'm beginning in verse 1, "the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Israel, and say to them, the feasts of the Lord, which you shall proclaim to be holy convocations, these are my feasts." And I know I said that last week as we were talking about the different feasts that were coming up, and there's actually one more biblical feast for the year. The feasts are these, and that is Passover, Feast of Unleavened Bread, First Fruits. These are the spring feasts, and actually one more, and that is Pentecost. These four are in the spring of the year, and the Christian correspondence to those for the Passover is the Passover lamb is sacrificed. And of course, that would, in our Christian walk, refers to the death of Jesus Christ. He became our Lamb of God, sacrificed for the sin of the world. The unleavened bread. He was without sin, sinless. Unleavened bread has no leaven in it, so it does not, it's a flat bread, but leaven throughout the Bible is considered as sin. First fruits, his resurrection was the first fruits of being born again, of a new life that we could step into. He was the first of the resurrection. He was the first fruit of the sacrifice that he made. So he was both the sacrifice and the first fruit. Following that, he said, there's a gift from the Father that I want you to have. There is a gift, he told his disciples, go to the upper room and wait for the gift. And that gift was the anointing and the coming of the Holy Spirit. And we commonly refer to that in our Christian walk as Pentecost. We say Pentecost because it's 50 days after his resurrection. But these are Jewish feasts now. Pentecost was 51, was the Feast of Weeks in the Jewish cycle. Following that, and the one the two that we just recently had was the Feast of Trumpets. That at the blowing of the trumpet, it was an awakening or a rallying or a call to alertness to be aware of the presence of the Lord. And we recently celebrated that here along with the Jewish nation who celebrated the Feast of Trumpets. And last Friday, we had the Feast of Atonement. This particular feast was when the price was actually paid, where your sin, the process of the feast in the Jewish for the Jewish people is the transference of sin to a scapegoat. Transference of sin. Does that sound familiar in your Christian walk? Yes, because Jesus took our sin upon himself. And the final of the feasts of the Lord, the one that's coming up this week, is called the Feast of Tabernacles. And this is most important to understand because the Feast of Tabernacles is one where it says that God will come and tabernacle, stay, be with us. And that feast is coming up this week. And we're so excited to join with celebrating the Feast of the Lord, because didn't the presence of God say to us, as his promise, as Jesus articulated while he walked the earth, I will never leave you nor forsake you. That's the tabernacling. That's the tabernacle of the presence of the Lord with us. And when we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, when we say, yes, Lord, we want you to tabernacle with us, to be with us. He comes into our hearts, and we no longer are on our own. We no longer are enemies of the things of God. And yes, the Lord comes and tabernacles with us. What a tremendous, tremendous gift that the Lord has given us in the death, the sacrifice, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And these seven feasts, these feasts proclaim to us those things. They proclaim Jesus in each of the feasts. And it was amazing to me when I first started to study these feasts, and I could see Jesus in them. I was amazed at the fact that in the nation of Israel, from childhood on up, they celebrated these feasts, but they could not see Jesus in them. They couldn't see the fulfillment of those feasts in the embodiment of Jesus Christ. And I ask you today, do you see that Jesus has fulfilled each of these feasts? And these feasts are of the Lord. Let me read this again, because nowhere in Scripture is it more direct a statement from God. He says this very directly. He says, the feasts of the Lord, which you shall proclaim to be holy, holy convocations, holy gatherings, holy times, a holy season, that you're going to proclaim these to be a time to be separate and set apart and focusing on the things of God. These feasts of the Lord, he said, I want you to know something. These are my feasts. You can read it for yourself in Leviticus 23:2. He says, these are my feasts at the end of the verse there. And so when we take a look at these feasts, and every year we step into these feasts and we step into and recount really throughout the calendar year, we recount the steps and the process and the life of Jesus Christ as the fulfillment of these feasts. What an amazing thing that we have really a pathway to understanding everything Jesus's life came to symbolize, came to be actually in our walk as Christians. And when we get this understanding of the fulfillment of these feasts in Jesus, we say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, come and tabernacle with me. Come and be with me. Lord, I lay myself down so that you can come and be with me. The interesting thing of the Feast of the Tabernacles and the celebration of it, in some of the Jewish communities, even around Pittsburgh here, you will see where they have actually set up, they call them a lean-to. It's a little side shelter. And in this booth, they are celebrating God's provision for them. In fact, let me just read this as I did to my church here recently. The Feast of Tabernacles, this festival commemorated God's deliverance, protection, and provision during the wilderness wanderings of the Exodus. It is also known as the Feast of Booths. and the Feast of the Ingathering. People lived in booths or huts made from limbs, remembering their wilderness experience. It also celebrated the autumn harvest, and it will be celebrated in the millennium, according to Zechariah 14. It's a time to celebrate the harvest. This, in the natural, is the season of harvest. The fall season is when the farmers start to bring in the crops of the year. They start to see what kind of a year their produce has produced, their plants, their fields have produced. It's the ingathering of all of that in the natural, but it also celebrates the ingathering of the Lord for his people. And we are so excited that, this week is the Feast of Tabernacles. This week is a time when the Lord proclaims, I can't wait for the ingathering of my kids. I can't wait to take in all of you and receive you unto myself. Just like a farmer, you know, he sees his fields ripe and he sees them having grown and he sees a plentiful harvest coming. And he just can't wait just to go and harvest those crops, harvest that provision from God. Well, that's the heart of the Feast of Tabernacles. That's the heart that says, yes, Lord, here I am. I am yours. Take me. Take me. When we take a look at these Jewish feasts and we see what God has done in preparing the nation of Israel, I just feel, and I was saying this recently to my church, I was just saying, you know, there is so much that we sometimes think that, oh, I can't understand why, the nation of Israel or the Jews may not understand or can't see Jesus in all of these. But there is going to be a day when we will be the ones who, even having seen Jesus, I believe the nation of Israel is going to expound and going to share with us these particular things that they grew up with that we maybe don't know. And it'll be a glorious day when all those who are the Lord's come together and share with one another, and the family of God comes together. That's what the Feast of the Ingathering is. That's what the Feast of the Tabernacles is about. It's a celebration. It's a time to look forward to the ingathering of the body of Christ. And, you know, there's a lot of different things that we may not understand. There are things that are written in the Jewish writings that when you hear of them, when you see of them, you start to think, wow, they know this thing. For instance, and this is just a small example, every year at this time, they would hang on the door of the temple a cord of crimson red. And they did not understand that, but that cord, for through no known reason, known to the ancient Jewish scholars, known to the ancient scribes and Pharisees, that crimson red cord would turn completely white. It's written of in the Talmud. And they, for generations, decades, generations, would hang that crimson red cord on the door of the temple and it would turn white. And then they said in the writing, somewhere about the early part of the century, somewhere around maybe 30-35 AD, all of a sudden, it did not turn anymore because the provision had been made in Jesus Christ. The provision had been made in Jesus Christ. And so now the crimson red cord remained crimson red. When I heard that, I said, my goodness, My goodness, all the things that God has laid out and has put before scholars and those of understanding, and these are things that they know, but they just counted them as a mystery. And yet God was clearly saying, there has been provision. Though your sins were red as scarlet, I will make them white as snow, says the scriptures. And in these things, these examples, these feasts that God has laid out, we are able to see how God loves his people. And it's his heart's desire that none should perish, but it all would come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. What an amazing God we serve. What an amazing God. And, you know, we don't have to wait for the annual feast or the Feast of Tabernacles to have God with us. Maybe you've never made a confession for Jesus Christ as your Lord. Maybe you're like, wow, I need to do this. It doesn't have to be anything grandiose. It could be just as simple as you being alone in your room even and just saying, Lord, I want to know you better. I lay myself down and I receive Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. Take my sin and give me his righteousness. And those simple words alone, you reveal your heart and you reveal your heart's desire. And God has never turned anyone away who has declared that, who has requested that, who has prayed that type of a prayer. Now, it doesn't have to be exactly those words, but just ask the Lord to come into your heart. Ask him to make you one of his own. Ask him that and that you would become one of the children of God. You know, we're all God's creation, but only those who ask are invited into his family. And he does it with open arms. And I'm not talking about any type of doctrine or any type of religion, any particular church. I'm just talking about the same Bible that we all have. And in there it says, these feasts were to show the children of Israel and prefigure the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the final feast, the Feast of Tabernacles, was that God desires to tabernacle with you. Wow, where does the time go when we start these? I could go on for so much longer. Well, this is the week that we celebrate that particular Feast of the Lord. And I hope that if you're tuning in, even if you were flipping channels, you didn't tune in by accident. And you can take a look, whether you're in Bethel Park or Peters Township, take a look at the cable listings and see if they can, when they'll be running the show again, if you missed part of it. Because this is a very important show. It's about the ingathering of the children of God. And you don't want to miss that. That's all the time we have for today. God bless you. The name of our church is In His Presence. We're at 251 Brookwood Road in the Peters Township area, just off of McMurray Road near St. David's. We're in the educational building across from the sanctuary at Peters Creek United Presbyterian Church. We meet every week there at 10 o'clock. I would love to have you. Even just stop in and say, hey, I saw the TV show. I just wanted to come and visit for today. We would love to have you. God bless you. Have a great day.